Hello, my name is André Altman, and I'm going to be talking to you about the MSc program in Artificial Intelligence and Medical Imaging, which is based at UCL's Department of Medical Physics and Biomedical Engineering. As you might have heard, there's a lot of workflows in healthcare settings, and they rely on an ever-increasing amount of medical imaging data or medical data. And the use of artificial intelligence in these healthcare settings is, of course, on the rise. So we prepare our graduates to engineer AI-driven systems for medical use. We prepare them to engineer AI solutions to provide faster and more accurate diagnosis. And we prepare them that they will be able to develop and apply AI methods for medical image analysis. And lastly, our graduates are equipped to design efficient AI-enabled workflows for healthcare settings. So in this program, you will learn about two different things, which come together in the end. So the first one is a full range of medical imaging methods, the science behind them, and also what kind of treatments they inform. And there are classic things like X-ray, there's CT imaging, there's MRI imaging, there's photoacoustic imaging, and so on. And the most important part for this program, or what is distinctive about this program, is that you also learn about how we can use artificial intelligence in order to improve the kind of information that we get out of this medical imaging data, and how we can combine this in order to extract more valuable diagnostic information from those data. So for instance, there are approaches where we use artificial neural networks to segment important aspects in the images. There are ways that we can use a smart way of upsampling the resolution of images, which is called image quality transfer. There are ways that we can make long-established medical imaging tasks like image registration, we can use artificial intelligence to speed them up in order to have real-time information and updates in the operating room, for instance. So this program is hosted at the Department of Medical Physics and Biomedical Engineering. And this department has a very long-standing history. It's the longest established and largest medical physics department in the UK. Its history starts dating back to 1896, when the first X-ray device began to operate in a nearby Middlesex hospital. And in 1913, Sidney Russ was appointed the world's first hospital physicist at the Middlesex Hospital. And in 1920, he became the Joel Professor of Physics Applied to Medicine, which was the first chair of medical physics in the world. So as you can imagine, combining medicine and physics is already a multidisciplinary task. So our department is highly multidisciplinary, where researchers often work in very close collaborations with a diverse group of researchers in other fields like medicine and hospital and research centers. And in recent years, of course, with the rise of AI, the portfolio also encompassed more and more computational approaches in addition to classic physics and also medicine. So our department has access to a wide range of facilities. So first of all, because it's a medical physics department, we have lab space where we can, you know, develop new methods for medical imaging and medical physics. They can be tested, which is also a place where we can collect initial data, prototype data of new devices and new imaging methods. Then there are collaborations with UCL Hospital, for instance, where we have access to proton beam therapy. And last but not least, for all our artificial intelligence approaches, we also have access to a lot of compute. So our department has various types of research interests and research strengths. So one, of course, is medical imaging, covering the classics like magnetic resonance imaging and CT. And there's radiation physics, which includes X-ray imaging, but also how we can treat patients using nuclear medicine. There is a section that is working on implanted devices. This can be used, you can think of a pacemaker, but there's also pacemakers for the brain. So last but not least, there's also a strong computational research interest in our department. One of the aspects is computer-assisted surgery, and the other one is everything involving AI and robotics. You can think of a robot-enabled operating room and all the image analysis that we're conducting with artificial intelligence. As you can imagine, the department has a lot of collaborations all over the campus with other institutes at UCL, but also with local hospitals where we collect data and engage with researchers there on their specific problems. We also have collaborations with industry. There are a lot of spin-outs that come out of UCL And we have a long-standing history in collaborating with researchers that are still working at those companies. And last but not least, your research project in the MSc program will be a very good opportunity to collaborate across various disciplines. So many of our projects involve not only an academic in the medical physics department, but also close collaborators somewhere at another place at UCL, potentially directly at a hospital, or maybe in an industry partner. So the MSc in AI and medical imaging is not the only MSc program in our department. We have a long-standing MSc program in physics and engineering and medicine. And we also have an MSc program in medical robotics and artificial intelligence. In addition to those postgraduate thought programs, we also have an MRAS program, which is more heavy on the research project. And we also have a PhD program in MedPhys and biomedical engineering. Alongside these postgraduate courses, we also have undergrad courses in biomedical engineering and medical physics. And when you're taking your degree here, so lots of the modules that you will be taking will be joined with some of the other MSc programs. So you will get in touch with a lot of students with a slightly different angle on what they're studying. So particularly on this MSc in AI and medical imaging, this was established in 2023, and it emerged from the medical image computing specialization of the physics and engineering and medicine MSc. So we notice a growing interest in research, translation, and commercialization of AI-enabled medical software and devices. And this prompted us to revise our taught program in this space in order to focus more emphasis on the backgrounds of artificial intelligence and how they can be used alongside medical imaging. The program is designed to provide you with a deep understanding and the science behind the medical imaging devices and methodologies. But also, it's designed to provide you the foundations of machine learning and artificial intelligence. And last but not least, this program brings together the challenges that are particularly important when you're working with artificial intelligence in the context of medical imaging data, and how those prototype systems, for instance, can be then translated to successful healthcare solutions. Who is this program designed for? So when we designed the program, we had in mind that it should be for students who are keen to develop AI-enabled solutions that can be employed in a healthcare setting. So students should be interested in applying AI, you know, for instance, for medical imaging data, but also in other medical data that are collected, for instance, in a hospital, and maybe combining those with the available medical imaging data. Successful completion of the program will enable you to solve practical problems that are arising when deploying such a system for medical use. But also, you will be equipped to critically assess the current limitations of using AI applied in the context of medical imaging. So the program will also equip you to solve complex problems in a systematic fashion, either individually or within a group. So for instance, your research project will be mostly done individually with interactions with other researchers. But along with in other modules, we have group courseworks, for instance, that allow you to work in a small team in order to solve a specific challenge, improving your teamwork skills and communication skills as well. So graduates of our program are very well equipped to essentially start working in high-tech startups. In startups involving medical imaging research, for instance. They're equipped to work with established healthcare providers, and of course, based on the curriculum, you also be very well equipped for further doctoral studies. This program is structured around a number of compulsory and optional modules. This means that you can choose to personalize your learning based on individual interests and desired specialism. To view extensive module information for this program, please visit the prospectus page. So here are some recommendations in order to be successful in your application. So this is a quite maths-heavy curriculum, so that's why we require a degree in computer science, engineering, or physics, or related field. And of course, when you're working on artificial intelligence projects, those will be coding-based. So we will also require a solid programming experience. You could showcase this, for instance, by adding, you know, GitHub links and similar things to your CV so that we can see and assess that you worked on relevant coding projects. Of course, and most importantly, you should showcase in your cover letter that you have passion for applying artificial intelligence to biomedical and healthcare problems. Perhaps you had a small project already where you engaged with this. So this is very, very important to highlight so that we understand what your motivation is for joining the program. And of course, you should be, you know, enjoy problem solving and innovating. And you should be very interested in, you know, seeing your future in what's possible in medical imaging and what we can do to redefine healthcare using artificial intelligence in medical imaging. For further information on entry requirements, fees and application closing dates, you'll need to visit the program prospectus page. This is also where you'll find a link to make your application. So being part of the UCL community is inspiring and life-changing in many ways, not just academically. We're located in the heart of London, which was recently ranked as the best student city in the world in QS Best Student City Ranking 2025 for the sixth consecutive year. This means that access to UCL's state-of-the-art campus facilities is complemented by proximity to famous museums and galleries, esteemed libraries and professional associations, and first-rated entertainment and nightlife. This map shows where our two main campuses are based. There's Bloomsbury on the left and UCLE on the right. The pink dots are UCL accommodations and the blue dots are UCL campus buildings and facilities. Our accommodation services team is also able to offer support to students on alternative accommodation, such as renting privately or via University of London Housing Services. UCL Students Union has over 300 clubs and societies, so there's always the opportunity to pick up a new hobby or meet new people. Engineering-specific societies include the Fleming Society, UCL Racing, the AI Society, the Healthcare Innovation Society, and there's so many more. The union also provides sports, fitness, and entertainment facilities. You can get involved in representing Team UCL socially and competitively. The union also provides advice and support in case you find yourself struggling. There is a team of well-being, disability, and mental health experts at hand at UCL Student Support and Well-being. Equality, diversity, and inclusion are fundamental to the ethos of UCL. We were the first university in England to admit women students on equal terms with men in 1878. We encourage open-mindedness. You will learn how to think, not what to think, with us. We're proud that UCL is London's global university with students from 150 countries and 400,000 alumni worldwide. Thank you for watching, and we're looking forward to welcoming you at UCL on the programme.